how much information does Google really know about us? If I'm targeting audiences with my YouTube ads, how accurate is that targeting? I want to explore this today by looking inside my own Google profile, and we're going to look at the interests that Google thinks I have, and we're going to see how accurate this is. And of course, I'm going to show you how you can look inside your own profile for the same information. My name is Kyle Sulerud. I'm the founder of AdLeg, a marketing agency that specializes in YouTube ads. And today I want to look specifically into one type of targeting that you can use with YouTube ads, which is audience targeting. So Google takes people and they put us in these different audiences based on what they think they know about us. And they know quite a lot. They know what we're searching for on Google. They know what we're watching on YouTube. They know what we're looking at when we're browsing other websites. Google knows a lot, of course, but do they know everything? How accurate are they when they're placing us in these different audiences and they're assuming they know things about us and they know the types of things that we are interested in? How close are they going to get? To find out, I'm going to go look at my own ad personalization settings. Now you can do the same thing just by going to adssettings.google.com. And then what you'll find is your ad personalization profile. For starters, you could turn this personalization off, which means you're never going to see ads from Google that are specifically targeted at your interests. You'll still see ads, but they'll be more related to the content of videos you're watching or the content of websites you're browsing. They won't be targeted at you personally. But honestly, who wants that? We want ads that are relevant to us. So I'm not telling you to turn the personalization off. I would definitely recommend leaving it on, especially if you are an advertiser. You want to see who's advertising to you, how they're advertising to you. Just seeing other people's ads is a learning experience. So let's take a look at the interests and the personalization that Google has inferred about me. Now, the age and gender, these are things that I've actually told Google. When setting up my Google account, I gave them my birthday, I told them that I was male. So these things are pretty well set in stone. At the top here, below the age and gender, what you're probably going to find are some different companies that you've interacted with. These are going to be companies that basically have you on their retargeting list. So if I were to pull up VRBO, it tells me this advertiser shows you ads based on my visit to their website or app. Now I could turn this off if I really want to, if I'm getting a lot of ads from a particular advertiser because they're retargeting me and I want to stop seeing those ads. I can turn that off here if I really want to. But that's what you're going to find at the top are actual companies that are retargeting you. Below that then are all of these different interests. Now it's definitely interesting some of these interests that they have me in. For example, Android OS. I don't use an Android. I never have. Nobody in my family does. I have no idea how they've put me with this Android OS interest. Now, some of this stuff is somewhat relevant, you know, baby feeding. Yes, I do have a baby. I do feed that baby. I figure it's the right thing to do. Business productivity software. I do run a business. I do use various types of software for that business. Campers and RVs. Yes, I did recently buy an RV. So that's probably how I ended up in this audience. Some of these are just really broad, like beaches and islands. I mean, who isn't interested in beaches and islands? Or apparel, or beauty and fitness. I'd be more interested to know who isn't in some of these categories. Let me look at beaches and islands. So it's telling me that Google estimates this interest based on my activity on Google services. So I don't know when it happened, but apparently I was watching or searching for something about beaches and islands. Again, this probably applies to a lot of people who are looking into any kind of vacationing or traveling or anything like that. Apparently, I'm interested in Canada. That's definitely news to me. A lot of video gaming stuff. You see casual games, computer games up here, adventure games, action and platform games. I'm really not into video games at all, so I don't know where it's getting all of this. Now, this is potentially because this is a shared computer, and my wife and kids use this computer, and they're not logging in and out of my account. They're doing stuff while they are logged into my Google account. And that's gonna happen all the time. Anyone that shares a computer with someone else, you're going to have cross-contamination of interests, where I could be using the computer and I'm seeing ads that are more relevant to my wife because she was previously using the computer. So what else do they know about me? Education status, bachelor's degree, that is correct. Google estimates this demographic because my activity on Google is similar to people who have told Google that they are in this category. Now, I honestly don't know how anyone tells Google that they have a bachelor's degree. As far as I know, there's no setting that you can go and tell this information to Google. So I'm not sure how they even get that starting point. Obviously, they need a starting pool of people who have told this to Google, and then they're saying, okay, Kyle, you're similar to those people, so you must have a bachelor's degree also. But I'm not sure where they're even getting that starting pool of people from. Flowers is an interesting one. When I was showing this page to my video producers before we started filming, they both had flowers in their profiles too, and none of us have any idea how we got pegged as having an interest in flowers. So I'm curious if this is just one of those things that pretty much everybody has. Let me know in the comments. Do you have flowers as one of your interests according to Google? Or do you somehow not have flowers as an interest? And if not, like, why are you not interested in flowers? Flowers are great. Moving down the list, homeownership status. Yes, I am a homeowner. Job industry. Yes, you could say I'm in the technology industry. Household income, high. Here too, Google is estimating this because my activity is similar to people who have told Google they're in this category. I don't know where you can go tell Google what income category you are in, so I don't know where they're getting this starting pool, but that's where they have me. Jazz, they know that I like jazz. They know that I'm married. They know that I'm interested in Nebraska. Actually, no idea why Nebraska is showing in my interest. I can't think of a single thing I've ever looked for or looked up in relation to Nebraska. No offense if you're from Nebraska. And here's another very sparsely populated area, North Dakota. But yeah, I actually live in North Dakota, so they got this one right. Parental status, 5 factors. And it's saying parents of infants, parents of toddlers, parents of preschoolers, parents of grade schoolers. So my kids would only fall into 2 of these categories, the 0 to 1 year old category and the 6 to 12 year old category. So Google's a little bit off when it comes to the ages of my children. Here's some more gaming stuff, social networks, smartphones. I don't know, again, who would not be on these lists? Who doesn't have a smartphone? Who's not on a social network? More video game stuff, a bunch of different TV genres, urban transit. So I can't think of the last time I rode a bus. I've never ridden a subway. I should not be in this urban transit interest. Video game development, that's stretching it. I have no interest. I've never looked at anything related to actual video game development. And I'm pretty sure nobody using my computer has either. So there you have it. That is the profile that Google has on me. They got a lot of stuff right, but there are a lot of interests on there that really don't apply to me. So if advertisers are targeting me based on those interests, they're targeting the wrong person, they're wasting a lot of money. And really, that's just one thing you have to keep in mind when you're running Google Ads, when you're running YouTube Ads, is that when you're targeting audiences, there will be people in those audiences who are the perfect customers for you to target, but there will also be people who don't belong there. It just is what it is. You have to deal with it. And that's why sometimes audience targeting doesn't work very well. Luckily, this is just one type of targeting we have at our disposal with YouTube ads. There's a lot of other targeting. And of course, I've made a lot of videos about each of the types of targeting that you can check out for yourself. Now, I want you to let me know in the comments, what were some of the weirdest interests that Google had listed for you in your profile? Again, if you go to adsettings.google.com, you can see your own profile. And I'm curious to know what you have. Maybe it's flowers, maybe it's something else, but what really did not fit for you? If you're interested in running YouTube ads with the help of my agency, then click the link in the description. You can learn more about working with us. Again, my name is Kyle Sulerud. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.